This is Daily Devotions with God and Broken Pieces. I'm Precious, the heart behind God and Broken Pieces. Good morning, Healing Nation. Thank you so much for being here. In today's Daily Devotions, we get our scripture reference from the book of Ezekiel, chapter 1. I went before the Lord. This is the word that He gave me from last night, and I continue to read this morning as well. This chapter is so deep and it's so intricate that it took me 2 days from last night until this morning to read the whole thing and actually grasp it and let it sink in. And the enemy tried to distract me, but I thank God that He allowed me to get this far with the word. And we see here in this chapter that the glory of the Lord is revealed. The glory of the Lord is revealed. I don't know about you, but by the time I got to the last verse of the chapter, I just felt the presence of God so heavy, because initially when I started reading, I didn't really fully know what the chapter is about. It took me on a journey and began to engage my imagination, because we see how the Lord appeared to Ezekiel and began to give him visuals and began to paint a picture of who He is and just how much of weight His glory carries, and really how we can never really fully fathom Him, and He can appear as anything to anybody. He truly can be anything to anyone, and He cannot be likened to anything. If you think about when you were growing up, like for example, I remember a time when I was bullied due to some of my body parts, and I remember my family members saying that you need to respond by saying that you were made in the image of God. And I was wondering, but how does God look like? If you were to paint a picture right now of how God looks like, when the word says we were made in His likeness, what does that refer to? What does that mean? Have you ever thought about that? And have you ever gotten an answer? So I thank God that as we go through the scriptures, we are able to find Him, we are able to see Him, and we are able to see ourselves in Him. And so that question was answered over time. And Genesis chapter 1 really shares with us how God created everything and how He got to create us as human beings, how He got to the decision of our makeup and what He was going to put into us. And unlike all the other creatures, He chose to make us like Himself. There isn't any other creature on earth that He made like Himself, including the angels are not like Him. And all of us are significant in our own way. However, we are the ones who bear His likeness. And I just feel the presence of God on that. And I just want you to allow yourself, as you go through this Ezekiel 1, to be immersed. Let your imagination be engaged. Let your imagination run. Let the Holy Spirit put images and pictures in your mind, in your brain, in your spirit, in your heart, so that you can be able to understand how big God is. If He was to show up in physical form, how do you think He would look like? If He just decided He wants to rock up, we see that He incarnated Himself and came in a form of a human being. And we see how that played out, the power that exuded out of Jesus Himself when He walked the earth. I'm not necessarily talking about Him incarnating Himself. If He was to show up as God Himself, we see Ezekiel struggling to grapple with what he's seeing, and he's trying as much as he can to share with us what he saw and what that meant to him. He's trying as much as he can to really explain the sounds that he heard and the majesty that he saw. I like how he's sharing with us in detail, how he engages our imagination as well, to say, I looked and behold, this is now in verse 4, a stormy wind came out of the north, a great cloud with brightness around it and fire flashing. And verse 5 talks about, in the midst of it came the likeness of four creatures. So God can come and appear in any form, in any likeness. He can appear in any form and in any likeness. And he's talking about these four creatures, each having four faces. And these four faces have the appearance of an eagle, the appearance of a lion, the appearance of an ox, and the appearance of a human being. And we see that there is a representation there. And there is a reason why those ones are the ones that were selected. What an eagle stands for, what a lion stands for, what a human stands for, and what an ox stands for. The glory of the Lord. Who can be able to contain? Who can be able to stand in the presence of the Lord? When the Lord appears himself in your life and in your situations, nothing can ever be able to stand. It gets quite hectic. It escalates from verse 16 up to verse 28. And I really encourage you to read this Ezekiel chapter 1. It's just full of the glory of God. Really, you will be amazed, because it's talking about the wheels. There's something also about the, it's so intricate and it's so deep on a spiritual level. But what I'm taking away from this today, and what I would like us to focus on, is the weight and the beauty of the glory of God. David said himself that he wants to be in the house of the Lord. He would rather be found in the house of the Lord to behold the beauty of the Lord all the days of his life. The beauty of the Lord, the beauty of the Lord. This is what Ezekiel was exposed to. He got a taste, he got a glimpse. And he says here that the wheels were constructed and they were gleaming with beryl. These are expensive material. And the rims were tall and awesome. And he's talking about the spirit were in the wheels. And he's talking about what was over the head of these living creatures was like shining like awe-inspiring crystal, and covering and each creature had two wings covering its body. And when they made a sound, when the wings made a sound, it was like a sound of many waters. And then he comes and says, like a sound of tumult, like the sound of an army. So he's trying to make sense of what does this sound like. And the scripture also, I think it's David, if I'm wrong, you will correct me, you will forgive me, but it's in the word where David talks about God's sound being likened to thunder. You know, that how does God sound like? If he was to be audible right now, will we even hear him? So Ezekiel here is trying to give us also an imagination of audio, that what did he hear? How did it sound like? If God was to appear now and speak, how will that sound like? So when we hear the oceans, that is a representation of God. When we speak, that is a representation of God. When we hear thunder, everything that he has created, when we hear the wind, creation is just the manifestation of his glory and how much he is so adorned and how much he is so majestic, because he created that. That's why we shouldn't be worshiping creation, because creation was created by the Creator, and the Creator is above all creation. And also that's why you shouldn't underestimate yourself, because you were created in his likeness, and he invested in you and he put in you a portion of himself when he breathed life into you. You are just like him, and all these things he created with his mouth, just like he also gave you creation power. So there is a lot that we can get from the word of God that can really build our confidence and expose us to another side that we haven't necessarily been exposed to before. I hope you are encouraged. At the end here, we see how Ezekiel is really trying to indicate to us the weight of this glory. The weight of his glory sent him to fall on his face when he heard the voice of the one who was speaking. He couldn't contain himself. It was too much. Eventually, he ended up falling on his face. And that is the posture that we need to maintain at all times. That's what happens with the angels. They behold the beauty of the Lord, and the whole day they keep bowing up and down. They bow down, and when they come back up, they see the glory and the beauty of the Lord. God and they bow down again. So that's what we want to maintain as well. When we keep our focus on God, it's not possible that we will not continue to maintain a posture of worship. So what are you focused on today? Because when you're focused on your problems and focused on what the world is saying, and when you are focused on everything else that is happening, obviously worry is going to overwhelm you. But when you behold the beauty of the Lord constantly, you will have your heart bowed, and all that you are constantly bowed to the Lord and having the glory of the Lord flow in you and through you and into your life as a whole. And it's not possible that you can have an encounter with the Lord and he doesn't affect and infect your situations. So thank you for being here for Daily Devotions with God and Broken Pieces. Remember to subscribe, share this video with as many people as you can, and read this Ezekiel so that you can be able to experience this glory for yourself. Until we meet again, see you next time. I feel tempted to make reference to these movies that we watch, that sometimes we see creatures in the movies, and the way that they are portrayed, they're actually even used for bad sometimes and even for evil. But we see that nothing that is on earth actually does not come from the Word. Everything comes from the Word, but the enemy takes it and perverts it, and he takes it and he put his own thing to it, like how he discredited marriage, how he took the value out of the intimacy between men and women. All those things are in the Word, and when you go into the Word, you find the purpose of why God created these things. And we see that God is actually the one who created all these things, including ourselves, the way we function, our desires, our will, our ability to choose, our gifts and talents. But the enemy wants to come and steal that away from us so that he can pervert it and use it for his kingdom and use it for destruction, even to the destruction of our own lives. But God meant it for good. Thank you so much for being here. I hope this video has blessed you. Please remember to subscribe and like.